Chase Bank warns panic. Actually, it's Jamie Dimon. Wonder if there's anything up his sleeve. And Kitty or Skylar drop the screen.
Boss, I'm still here on location at Disneyland. I don't think Kitty's a good addition because I don't think you want your channel trending for here, kitty, kitty, kitty. And your audience was like, fire Skylar, hire Kitty. And that's not good job security. So I think you're gonna have to bring your screen down by yourself until I get back.
Well, I don't know, my friend. I'll do it myself. I think everyone kind of liked Kitty. A little bit. Maybe a little bit too much. And I clearly pushed the wrong button, but Jamie Dimon warns panic. I added that. Maybe added a little bit. But I mean, I'm pretty darn close. Would you not agree? Jamie Dimon, it's Chase Bank, warns panic. Unless I'm dyslexic and I read that as picnic. Will overtake markets. Oh, okay. As U.S. approaches debt default. You guys also know, again, I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. But when you have, okay, Janet Yellen, Treasury, calling CEOs and in panic, I think there might be a problem. We might be onto something. Oh, hey, JPM down. I want to show you some bank stocks too. Make a little money at shorting some of these. Yes, yes, I will. JP Morgan Chase CEO Dimon, Jamie Dimon, said on Thursday that markets will be gripped by panic. Okay, all right. You know, do you take them at their word or do you take them as like, everyone run, right? And then they're running the opposite way, grabbing all your money by panic as U.S. approaches a possible default on sovereign debt. Guys, we're not going to default on it. We could pay it. I mean, all they have to do is more taxes, right? Pay the interest on my bond. Yes, we're going to have to close some things. Wah, wah, wah. But it's not going to be like you wake up, you know, one morning and everything's on fire. The closer you get to it, you will have panic in the form of stock market volatility and upheaval in treasuries. He said such an event would ripple through the financial world, impacting contracts, collateral, clearinghouses, and a few more C's, which I showed you. I went back all the way to 2011, right? This was when we had the other debt crisis fiasco. Same players too. It's like they're like, we've seen this movie. We know how this goes down. After this green line, I'll show you, the market went down 18%. Actually, prior to it, I mean, from over here all the way down. This is when they're like, can't strike a deal. Just can't do it. I mean, from here to here, was it 30? Were we? Oh, 18%. Must have been measuring from the taint. But I mean, look at here, 07. Oh, everything's fine. Right, Jim Cramer? 2000, everything's fine. And now we climb this gigantic hill. And now, look, hold on. We're still up. And hey, I have a new green line. And I put that green line on this chart a year ago. And I said, after that line, okay, moving forward, financial conditions are going to get not so good. And some of you guys in the comments section, Jay Bravo, what happened to your prediction? Wait until the first week of May. That's when the Fed rate hikes will kick in. Yeah, it's starting now. Like, do you notice some problems in the market? And the white lion says it's going to send the market lower. Did you say you're right 80% of the time or wrong 80% of the time? And then I said I am wrong 99% of the time. Which in all fairness, guys, I started swing trading this. See the yellow line or the orange line? I don't know my colors anymore. And I told everyone, swing it up right here. That's when I launched my swing trading course. You want to know when I launched my bear market course? Yeah, right here. Swing it down. And then your fearful, frightened leader put up on his Bravo watch list, short SIVB, on Friday, February 17th at over $300. And it's not me who gets it right. It's just the lines that get it right. Also, I did say, I promised you this week, price is going up on my bear market. It's 20 bucks right now. But today's Thursday. Well, you have probably till today. Because this week it's either today or tomorrow. That's where I show you my trades, even though I do it on the channel too. Well, no, I don't. I keep those private. I have my privates that no one can see unless you pay for it. There's websites for that. Just sign up for it, kids. Looking at these trades, I did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But I've been making a whole lot more that I don't put on the channel. And I'm 5 out of 5 so far. And I actually broke my cardinal rule, because I guess the cardinals have rules. You don't swing down so much above the 200 that's actually moving in the upwards direction. But I just said, what the hell? You know, the MACD's lineup, I'll just do it on this channel. But this was 1, profit, 2, profit. And then I probably put in a short 3, profit, but on the channel. 4, 5, 6. Now I'm hoping it's going to trend down and then it's going to bounce off the 200 and we're going to put in a buy. Everyone is taking advantage of this. Jamie Dimon. They would love for this market to dump and then buy it cheaper. You don't want to buy high and sell. That's like retail traders. Oh my gosh, what's the next meme pumping? Whatever's hot. You got to own Tesla. You got to own. That's when you do the opposite. So, and Jamie is going to pick up banks too. This is beautiful. Oh my gosh. And he's like, oh, it's so bad. We have to just buy everything and make more money. This is horrible, and pass it on to you. Jamie Dimon says U.S. needs to finish the bank crisis, right? All of them. Take them all out. Not just that. He predicts more rules are coming to an industry already struggling. Yes, and whose fault is it? Do you want to know whose fault it is? Well, it's your fault. Look at this. Jamie Dimon says regulators should look at banning short selling bank stocks. I told you that's what they did before, because you can't have people like you and I making all the money. Oh, you want to know what else that little green line back in July 2011 was for? That was them telling you, you can't short the market. And guess what the market did? It actually went up for a few days. They're like, yeah, but then it crashed almost 20%. And you couldn't take advantage of it. And they would like to do it again. So hurry up and take advantage of what is happening, because windows open and windows close. Windows open, windows close. And when the windows close, you're gonna be like, shoot, I should have got his bear market watch list. That would have been great. I could have taken advantage of all this. As PacWest shares tumble 20%. After regional bank says deposits fell by 10% last week. 10% last week, 10% this week. We're moving our money out of your banks because we have to get a yield. Now, whose fault is that? Well, that's the bond market fault. Yes, the Fed does have influence over it, the short end. And look at these banks. Oh my gosh, 22%. This is horrible. Horrible. I mean, how dare people make money on the way down? Also, take it 70%. I said it right? 70. I never know. I'm like, shoot, I said 70. Okay. 70% off. Pick and choose whatever course you would like, which beats 60% off, which I've been doing all month. So that's like $299 for my courses. Dang it. I mean, that's just too cheap, Bravo. Stop. Okay, all right. So you could start with my swing trade, do my bear market, and then do a watch list, and do whatever one you want. I don't care. But look, or you could just move your money to 5.5. You want 5.5%? You call up your bank. Hey, Jamie, you know that I'm getting zero in my savings account and my checking. Can we do a 1 month T-bill? What's it paying here? 5.5, 6%? Yeah, I'll take that. And then poof, off the bank and into the bond market. And then the bank's like, no, we need that. You can't do that. Or poof, you move it into a money market and it off the balance sheet. That you can blame on the Fed. Actually, you can blame a lot on the Fed. And what are we up to, $3 trillion now over there, Jerome? And I think Jimmy, we haven't heard from Jimmy. Jimmy! What's up, buddy? What are we doing? Oh, he's selling today. Woo! I think he said last month, he's like, woo, it's done, it's over. Okay, this guy's smart too. Jim Cramer, he has a doctorate. Like, this is not a stupid guy, just to let you guys know. You know, we all make fun of him, but he has some money too. Repeat bankruptcies are piling up fastest. You don't leave out the word at. Since 2009, bankruptcy filings. 2009. I don't think that was a good year. Now I'm confused because our president said that the economy is strong as hell. Failing faster. I like that. Or falling faster. I don't know. And that's the other image they're using. One at Yahoo Finance is clearly drunk. Bankruptcies. Let's get married. Like, come on, you guys, you have a slew of Getty images to choose from. You go with this one. Here, why don't you let me help you? I'll draw it for you. See? Use something like this. Oh, and we have some breaking news. I just put my finger in a light socket. Big crypto exchange goes bankrupt. Bitrex just got wrecked. I know it was a few days ago, but I figured I'd tell you. The corn. You do that on your own time. It's not after 11:30 p.m. 26, we're in the 26 range now. Good job, Bitcoin. Maybe there was an earnings call or something like that. And also talking about earnings, breaking news, Disney. This is now. You guys should have known. Exit. That's what the E stands for, even though, you know, people are like, what an idiot. That's not what it stands for. Well, for me, it does because you never know. Exit prior to earnings, sitting right there on the 200. And now it's gone. And I say, go woke, get broke, hey, Mickey? Oh, if you say so, bravo. But, all right, well, here's a woke company not going broke. Hey, there's that 200. This was actually in my watch list. Watch it. Here we go, kids. This is where you put in a buy. Right there at 3:30. We've been waiting for this one. So you can pull it here. Or you can be a little bit more concerned. That's a pretty high price target. I'm going to say that'd be probably 420. Blaze, okay. Let me move it. I'm going to say, let's be a little bit less aggressive here. All right, let's go. Let's see if it actually does put us at 420. Let's pop this little guy up through the break. And 404. All right. 404, so we're... That's not good either. For those of you that have designed websites or own websites and you go to yours and you see 404, you know that's a problem. Well, you shouldn't be in incognito. But your life does not have to be a 404. You could take control of it, right? In some people's lives, like Jimmy, not too good on his calls lately of his entire career. We are near the end of deposit flight, May 1st, Kramer. But anywho, pop the confetti. Thank you for hanging out with me all the time. Make sure you take advantage before prices go up on actually having control over your life. So it doesn't end up looking like my hair. And I'll see you tomorrow.